South Africa, the easiest country in the world to find on a map. The instructions are right there. Recently, they've gone through a transition of power from Zuma to Ramaphosa that was so notorious any Americans heard about it. At the same time, though, there was another equally important transition of power that went underreported, probably in part because no Western news anchors could muster up the courage to try to pronounce Nhlanhla Nene. Let's see how I did.
Now, Finance Minister Nhlanhla Nene.
Now, if you're wondering where you might have heard of Finance Minister Nene before, for most of you watching this, it's less because of a previous successful term as Finance Minister for South Africa, and more because...
The opportunity for proper engagement is actually after the tabling of the...
It seems that Nene has become a meme. Sorry, I had to. Maybe he should join a standing committee. Alright, I'll stop. Today we're going to talk about several of the policies that Nene is bringing to the table. But first, I want to talk about his predecessor, Malusi Gigaba, seen here fighting diabetes in South Africa by crushing candy at a government meeting, was replaced. Well, as you know, the Gupta family probably listed Zuma and his cabinet appointees as dependents when filing their taxes. But there was another family who was in the news with this ex-finance minister this week.
Malusi Gigaba failed in his attempt to appeal against a high court judgment, which found he had lied under oath in his legal battle with the Oppenheimer family.
Yes, the Oppenheimers, who had also secretly negotiated deals with Minister Gigaba. So basically, this guy was not perfect. Plus, his big contribution to the South African economy was levying a value-added tax that raised prices across the board and was criticized for being unfairly burdensome to the poor. Now on to the man of the hour, Minister Nene. Minister Nene is currently in London doing maybe the hardest job since that poor diplomat who had to explain Trump's shithole comment to South African leaders. I bet when he passed his foreign service exams, he didn't think his job would require citing Urban Dictionary. So what's he doing in London?
Well, Minister Nene told reporters in London, the country is telling a credible economic story and, buoyed by the recent political developments, will be looking to raise $3 billion, that's around 35 billion rands, from international bond markets.
Alright, so he's trying to raise 35 billion rand through bond sales. Sounds simple enough. Generally, when countries do this, it doesn't even make it to the back page of the newspaper. Nonetheless, warrants a world tour. So why is this different? Well, bonds are essentially IOUs, or money that the government takes now and pays back later. Only problem is, the value lies with the belief that the government will pay them back later. Otherwise, it's less an investment and more charity. In fact, it's gotten so bad that South Africa's current bond rating is junk with many rating agencies, meaning that it might actually have a better payout right now to buy re-election ads for Zuma than the South African bond. The two major problems facing this new bond sale are, first,
credit rating agencies and investors were keen to hear more about proposed land reforms and suggested the government will have concrete proposals on the table by August. He added that the issue has the potential to be abused for political reasons, this after the Democratic Alliance has warned plans to seize land without compensation would deter international investment and raise concerns about agricultural production.
I bet British credit rating agencies are a bit curious to hear more about the proposed take land away from white farmers without compensation constitutional amendment. Although, being that they are, like me, cold calculating capitalists, have fun saying that three times fast, they aren't so much concerned with the morality of this redistribution as they are with the potential hit to agricultural productivity, and getting assurances that their bonds will not be repatriated once they buy them. Now, the other problem is...
On Monday, Nene met with senior analysts from Moody's and Fitch Rating Agency to take them through plans to cut spending and increase revenues and look to increase the capacity of SARS to improve tax collection. It comes as Moody's is due to publish the result of a review for possible downgrade later this month, which could potentially take South Africa's credit rating status to junk.
Minister Nene's goal was to try and appeal to Moody's by saying he's going to cut government spending spending, increase revenue, and increase tax collecting capabilities, which is the trifecta of what bond investors like to hear. Only thing you're missing now is a cryptocurrency release, and you will have $20 billion before you can say, all I wanted was $3 billion. Since that meeting, it was actually announced that Moody's isn't downgrading South African bonds. And while other credit rating agencies like Standard & Poor's are maintaining their junk bond rating, Moody's will maintain that it is, in fact, the lowest level of investment quality. So great job, Nene! This basically means that South Africa can raise money without selling off its assets. Although, considering we've sold almost everything that isn't bolted to the ground, including our oil reserves, this is an even more significant victory. So this brings us to some of the longer term goals that Minister Nene has on his mind. In an interview he gave with NBC Africa, he seemed to have one thing specifically on his mind.
The structural reforms we're talking about, with confidence actually being at the base of it. Because if with confidence alone, actually, it's a currency on its own.
Minister Nene spoke about confidence so much, I thought I was watching an after-school special. All you have to do is believe in yourself and things will get better. Minister Nene is attempting to do this by reining in spending. And luckily enough for us, he's previously been finance minister, so we can see his track record. Here's a response to his budget from 3 years ago.
We believe that what the mini budget presented by the minister this afternoon is what, in all intents and purposes, could be called an austerity budget.
Yeah, while Zuma has been somewhat making it rain, it seems as though with Minister Nene, it's going to be more cloudy with a chance of drizzle. For people who like government spending on programs for social good beyond the necessities, Minister Nene might not be good for you. And of course, I'm talking about more than just the completely necessary infrastructure spending Zuma bravely implemented to remodel his home. I'm talking about the $100 billion nuclear power plant that Zuma wanted that Minister Nene dragged his feet on and Ramaphosa himself said South Africa couldn't afford. Spending $100 billion on nuclear power kind of feels like buying a summer home when you're still renting a small studio apartment. So I had one more question that was dogging me as I was learning more about this new finance minister. So you want to cut spending and increase tax collection and increase confidence. That makes sense. But why focus on bonds? I mean, it's odd to make announcements about cutting the national debt and then immediately head to Europe to try and sell bonds. That's like announcing you're going on a diet while you're knee-deep in KFC chicken bowls. Well, the reason is that the 2018 South African budget was kind of the last hurrah of the Zuma era, and was passed just before Minister Nene got into office and started trimming the fat. It has a 50 billion rand budget shortfall, even including the new value-added taxes, so he's trying to raise money to pay off the current government commitments. So there you have it, a new era in South African finance that will bring about fiscal conservatism with President Ramaphosa. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hey YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this last video. If you hate red ink as much as Ramaphosa, be sure to click that red subscribe button to turn it gray. And of course, click here for more episodes of Africa Wednesday. As always, thank you for watching.